What is up, YouTube? Woody here, and I'm back with another video. I apologize for not posting any videos for around a month or two now. I've had a lot of stuff going on in my life, and decided, Halo 5 came out, I purchased it, and I played the multiplayer, and I'm just going to give a short, quick review on it. Hopefully anywhere from 5 to 8 or 9 minutes. Okay. Initially, we'll start out with the gameplay. It sucks to say this, but it feels like Black Ops 3 and Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. I remember playing the Black Ops 3 beta a while ago. You know, you could slide, you could have like this power up or something, and you could like stop in the air and shoot. Well, you basically have all of that in this, in Halo 5. You're able to, no matter what, you know, if you jump in the air and you aim down the sights, and all weapons have sights now, you get, you know, a boost, hold you in the air for like anywhere from like three to five seconds, I believe. That's okay. You know, you slide. The button layout is really weird. Even with Bumper Jumper, which what I've been playing on, it just, you know, I go to crouch, and I melee, or I zoom in, or something. Not really zoom in. I apologize for that. But it's just weird because with all of these new things like the thruster pack, the smartling, and you know everything, I always get mixed up in throwing grenades. I'm so used to pressing left trigger to throw grenades, but now I'm pretty sure it's RB or LB. LB to throw grenades. That messes me up so many times. I've gotten killed billions of times. And by billions, I mean like maybe 20 or something. Due to the fact that I keep pressing LT to throw the grenade instead of LB. Another thing, Spartan customization, you know, you used to be able to edit emblems, you know, have like a Hello Kitty with like a triangle or a square or Satan summoning circle or something. Now you can't do that. It is all pre-made emblems. And I'm pretty sure you get emblems along the way, but there's 220 emblems. I'm pretty sure you start out with 13. Only 13 start out. That's fine. That's fine. Other than the fact you can't edit them at all except for the color. You cannot make any emblems by yourself like you used to be able to. It's all pre-made now. And I absolutely hate that. Now, ever since Halo 4? Halo Reach? Ever since Halo Reach, I apologize. You know, you could assassinate, and then Halo 4, I'm pretty sure they added different assassination skins or stances or whatever. Got that, you know, you got, you know, you can do your gender. Stance, emblem color, all that. You can edit your mask or your helmet, your body armor. But I'm pretty sure it's only your body armor. You can't. It's not like Reach where you can have like different shoulder pads and stuff, which is a little disappointing in my opinion. Next, we have possibly the worst thing I have ever seen in a video game, or at least in Halo. Remember all those times you grabbed a Mongoose and rushed to the middle of the map to get the one and only sniper, rocket launcher, Spartan laser? It's smack dab in the middle of the map. Either team can get it. But it's whoever gets there fastest, whoever, you know, if you get killed, get it or don't. That was fun. That was challenging. Well, now you have requisition packs. I apologize if I'm not pronouncing that correctly. We now have requisition packs. you have gold, silver, and bronze. Bronze, you have, or, let me get to say this first. There's rec points, or REQ points, or whatever. And that's how you purchase these requisition packs. Bronze is 1,250, silver is 5,000, and gold is 10,000. The only problem I have with this? Well, the two problems I have with this. One, silver and gold requisition packs you can purchase with real currency. You can get out your credit card, be like, hey, I'm gonna buy 20,000 gold packs for $3. And you can do that. That'll be a lot of money, and that'll be wasting a shit ton of your money that you could use for like coin subscriptions or something, but that's your choice. I don't like that. I wish it would have just stayed where you get requisition points and you can purchase these packs with those points instead of using in real life currency. Now to the fun part. Your collection. Power weapons, vehicles, and power-ups all come from requisition packs. You can no longer go to the middle and get that badass sniper rifle and fight to the death for the Spartan. No. Anyone can get it. Everyone. You could literally have the entire team with rocket launchers if they all use their rocket launcher requisition card at the same time. Oh, you know, I want this freaking fuel rod cannon. Well, boom, I'm gonna spawn with it instead of having to go and fight for it or go and grab it or pick it off a dead body. Nope. Just gonna spawn with it. I don't like that at all. It's stupid. I feel like unbalanced a little bit. And it goes the exact same with vehicles. You can spawn in with a vehicle. You no longer have to fight for it. You no longer have a limited supply unless you have one Banshee like I do. You have to use these cards to get power weapons and vehicles and not fight for it like you used to. I don't like that much. Some people might be like, that's fair. You have requisition packs, you get requisition points decently easy, and you can just buy all these packs and get all the weapons, or you can get real life currency. It's fair. In my eyes, it isn't. There's also just a few modes you can play. Warzone and Warzone Assault, which is 24 players, 12v12, or 18 minimum. And Arena, which comes with Team Arena, Slayer, Breakout, Free For All, and SWAT. Those are the only playlists. Those are the only game types you can play. I'm okay with that, because Warzone's basically big team. They got Slayer, Free For All, SWAT, basically all the essentials. They just left out Team Snipers and such, and I wish they would have that, but I can understand not having many game types who have the population in one area instead of like Reach, where there's like, we'll just go with like 28 game modes and there were like 3,000 and Team Death and 1,000 and Big Team. I can understand that. Where they're wanting to try to keep the games servers alive. It's not my cup of tea. I'll end the video here. I hope I shed some light on Halo 5 Guardians, if you want to purchase it. If you don't, this is really my first review, so I apologize if it's not incredibly amazing. I'm still working on my video editing software, and that's about it. I hope you enjoyed. I hope you enjoyed the gameplay clips of my horrible gameplay, because I suck at this game. But I will end the video here, and I hope you guys have a good one. Enjoy the rest of the clip if you didn't get that far. Peace out. The whole system's gone.
going now.